In the metals quadrant, most metals selling off today, copper down a little bit, but gold is really the big story. Down over 1.25%, actually down near 1.5%, 1.45% on the lows today, falling down to 1328. That's down about $20. And yesterday's high of 1343 and change remains the 2019 high. We did not make a new high in gold. This is the biggest down day in the yellow metal since August of 2018. So a pretty substantial sell-off. The trade deal is inching closer and closer to being a reality between the U.S. and China. That's part of what's pushing gold down today, the fear that this thing would just explode and there wouldn't be any sort of agreement between the U.S. and China seems to be fading into the background. So a lot of this is profit-taking. We're not seeing huge volume today, although it is more than an average day. It's not what you would normally see if this were just a complete long liquidation, but clearly some profit-taking going on after three consistent up days and a confirmation of the breakout that came January 25th of the sideways channel gold had been in for most of 2019. That breakout was confirmed by the three-day rally, and now with this news of the trade deal getting closer and closer, clearly some profit-taking is taking place. Also, the dollar rallied again today. It's now a two-day rally for the dollar index. That's helping push gold lower and really all commodities lower due to that inverse relationship. There's no direct gold news, although the seasonal tailwind is coming to a close as the Lunar New Year has now passed. We got the early buying from India. India buys a substantial amount of physical gold in the beginning of the year. So that seasonality is starting to fade into the background as well. So this gold sell-off may not necessarily be a change in trend, but it is something to keep an eye on going forward.